How quirky are you? Okay, I could ask that a different way. How quirky are you? Or how quirky are you? Or wait, how quirky are you? Anyway, I'm just trying it out. Hi there, I'm Phyllis Moore, Philosophically Speaking. Thanks for tuning into my channel today. If you're new, please click like, share, subscribe, comment, join the fray, if you will. But I often think of myself as quirky. So, you know, let's get that out of the way. Don't think I'm pointing fingers at you, because I'm not. But we all have our little idiosyncrasies and peccadillos and little habits and stuff. Some that we really don't care because that's the way we are. That's what makes us unique. We're fine, comfortable in our own skin. And others of us maybe don't really want people to know. And you know, I'll just put myself out there first so that maybe you'll be more comfortable, because no one ever has to know what your little quirks are. But I know when I go out, I go to the library, and I am happy to get all the freebies I can. When my kids were little, I would go on a Saturday. They were out of school, I was off work, and we would go and pick up then videos and magazines and books and whatever you could check out at that point in time. And I still do that. There might be free publications, you know, magazines, local newspaper, not newspapers, but you know, little like Penny Saver. I can't think of an example, but something like that, that would be little publications that are free or would be telling what continuing education or classes are going on at the community college, that kind of thing. And then there might be other things that are lying around that it's like, hey, take a bookmark with you. Okay. you know, you can check out magazines, you can check out DVDs, you can check out books on tape, that kind of thing. You know, there's nothing like it because they're all free and you can, you know, read and listen to your heart's content. So I am a fan. Well, likewise, there are other things that I enjoy doing. Like I would go to, you know, and it might be a Macy's, it might be a Belk, which is a Southern store, and you go in and you spray on, you know, some kind of perfume. Yay! I'm not gonna pay $75 for that, but I will spray it for free. And there are ones that I have loved and loved and loved, and you know, I probably can't pay for that on an ongoing basis, but it makes me happy to go in and get a free spritz, you know, that kind of thing. Free samples, you know, whether it's at a Sam's or Costco's, those kind of things, you know, where they give you, you know, whatever, a sample, a bite, a taste, whatever. It just makes you feel good. It's like you're getting a bonus in life, like finding a penny on the street. Those things make me happy. Now, in the climate we're in, these things are not happening. And it's a very sad loss for me. Because, and I know, you know, and not all of those that I just mentioned, but I know I have gone to Ulta. I'll give that example. You might be familiar with Ulta. And now that they've reopened, I will go in there and everything is hermetically sealed. It's like, you know, closed up tight as a drum, no sampling, no touching. If you want to buy something, you buy it and get out of here. That's the way it feels to me. And that's no disparagement on this particular store. But it's like, oh, what happened to all the little nuances? And I can't complain because that's where we are. And I don't want to out myself. But it's like, what's the point? What is the point if I can't go in and try on a sample? Or especially in that store, because a lot of it is makeup. And you're able to try it on and see if that's the right shade, the right color, the right product for your skin, that kind of thing. So for me, I don't shop as much because I don't know the rules. I don't know what they're going to allow, what they're not. And then when you go in and you realize, oh, everything is, you know, kind of off limits. But there's another one, and I don't know if this is true of other stores, but I do know in the case of the example I'll give, Whole Foods. I love to go in there and get a salad. Their salad bar is wonderful. And I have learned to try all kinds of different combinations because you can go and dip it on the plate and, you know, put it in there and you know, whatever, and sample it at home. But now the rule of thumb is you go in there, you summon a worker, and they come over and they prepare your salad for you. Well, I'm sorry. What's the fun in that? Because, and I actually said this to the person that assisted me recently. And I said, oh, now you're going to find out all my quirks. She did not crack a smile. Oh, come on. You know, whatever. Because I thought, you know, one dip of that and one, you know, they're rationing it for you. And it's like, you know, this is not going to bode well. I'm probably not going to go back. I'm not going to go through this every time. It's just too much, too much. And maybe other people like it and they realize this is what we have to do. That's old. It's old fast for me. So when she dipped the tomatoes and it's like, you know, I want more of those and I want some of that and I want some. And by the time I was done, it was just like, ugh, you know, I just felt like this is more information than I wanted to share. No one needs to know what combination of foods I get in my salad. It's just too much. I feel like I'm asking permission to be myself. And if you are in any part of the spectrum of OCD or, you know, let's say you go into whatever your routine is, if you touch the door and then you got to go touch it again, are you going to get someone to do that for you? No, you can't. And what if they say, I'm sorry, move it along. And you can't go back and touch it the same number of times that you always did. You know, what's that going to do to those of us who have quirky, different things that we do, little habits and little things that we don't want anybody to know about. No one can do it for us. And now they're not letting us. So we need to be free. We need to be free to be ourselves. I'll be glad when that happens because, you know, normal is not a word that means anything now. What is normal? I'm just saying, give yourself permission to be weird, unusual, outlandish, whatever it is. You don't have to out yourself. Find ways creatively to exist until we can get out and be free range again. But just know, you are not alone. I get it. Many of us get it. We're trying to white knuckle our way through. And in spite of businesses and entities trying to make it very, very difficult for us, we will prevail. We will get out there and be our odd, unusual, bizarre selves. Once again, the time will come for us to raise up and be touching everything in sight. You know, whatever, whatever. Just try to stay the course. Anyway, just wanted to check in with you. I hope you're having a wonderful, fabulous, safe day. Stay well. Thanks for tuning in. Don't forget to click like, share, and subscribe. I will be talking with you soon. Bye.